Just like to talk a little bit here about backsplash, front splash, and the blade going into the water. Theoretically, if you put the blade in the water, just directly into the water, then you won't have any backsplash or front splash. And as the blade, when it goes into the water, is well round towards the front of the boat, it's actually going in the same direction that the boat's going. And so it's quite easy to put a blade in if you practice it without having a lot of backsplash or front splash. So here we have an oar and we're just dropping it into the water so you can see what happens if the blade goes straight into the water. Something like that. No backsplash, no front splash, just straight into the water. What you can see, the splashing is mostly the shaft going into the water. So if instead I stop it before the shaft goes into the water, very little splash at all. So the concept that we should have a lot of splash when the blade goes into the water is one that we should perhaps avoid. So think carefully if you see backsplash or front splash and work out whether it's actually what you're looking for, when in reality, if you can and you put the blade into the water just like that, you'll find you get a cleaner connection and arguably a better connection. Here we have a piece of footage of Henry rowing in a boat, and he's demonstrating how we have a bit of backsplash. And if you watch the video carefully, and I've slowed it down so you can, you'll see that the backsplash actually creates a hole in front of the oar, which then, when he changes direction with the oar, creates a front splash. And so in essence, we've got backsplash then front splash. So when you look at it without being in slow motion, it looks a little bit like what we've got is the blade going in with a bit of front and backsplash. But if you look at it carefully, you'll see that there's backsplash, then there's front splash. The best answer clearly would be to avoid both and just put the blade in the water and just slide it in as smoothly as you can. So, interesting way of looking at backsplash and front splash, and be careful that what you're seeing is actually what's happening, because you may find that you're actually watching a movement that is backsplash first, front splash second, whereas if you were a little bit more careful at the catch and a little bit more leisurely at the catch, you may find you can put the blade in without any backsplash at all, or front splash. I think one of the reasons why athletes often put the blade in with backsplash at the catch is because they've been told that a couple of things. The catch is the final part of the recovery, agree completely, and they are also told often that you need to put the catch in as you're coming forward. Now, I don't think I quite agree with that. I think what should happen is that you should get ready to put the blade in as you're coming into the catch, yes. And as you're coming forward, what happens is you're getting ready for the catch, and as soon as you get to the front and you're essentially stationary but only momentarily, then you can put the blade in. Now, if you practice doing that, then you'll find that you get better catches and you'll get less backsplash, less front splash, people have more time to get connected and I get a more precise catch. I'd also suggest that if people get used to being patient at the front and not being in a hurry to get out of the front, so coming into the catch and not being in a hurry to reverse direction, then you'll find that you, if, as long as they don't have pressure on the foot plate, you'll find that you're not going to do any damage to the boat run, and they've got plenty of time at the catch to be able to come into the catch momentarily, and then when they get to the catch, put the blade in with not so much a pause but just gentle, and then drive from there. So I think if you find that athletes told to put the blade in when they get to the catch, I think that's going to be better. Even if they slow down that movement around the catch, as long as they don't have weight on the foot plate, I think you'll get better outcomes. But again, more easy to do with a more experienced athlete than a beginner, and so the answer with a beginner may well be to say the same way we've been teaching in the past, is put the blade in just as you're coming into the catch, and then once they get more comfortable at sitting at the catch position, then ask them to be more patient around the catch and get that blade in. And when they put the blade in, put it in and put it in well buried so that you get the best connection you can as early as possible in the stroke.